Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I welcome all of you to Good Friday evening service. That includes those of you joining us via Facebook and Zoom. Please rise if you're able for the call to worship. There is no greater love than this. The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified.
When I lift up from the earth, I will draw all things to myself.
He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering, acquainted with infirmity.
Surely he has borne our grief and carried our iniquity.
He was afflicted for our transgressions and crushed for our offenses.
On him was laid the punishment that makes us whole, and by his wounds we are healed.
Opening hymn is 298.
Thank you.
Our epistle reading tonight is from Hebrews. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a son, whom he appointed heir of all things. Through him, he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being. And he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. Now God did not subject the coming world about which we are speaking to angels, for someone has testified somewhere, "What are human beings that you are mindful of them, or mortals that you care for them? You have made them for a little while lower than the angels. You have crowned them with glory and honor, subjecting all things under their feet. Now in subjecting all things to them, God left nothing outside their control. As it is, we do not yet see everything in subjection to them. But we do see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, now crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. It was fitting that God, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the pioneer of their salvation perfect through sufferings. For the one who sanctifies and those who are sanctified all have one Father. For this reason, Jesus is not ashamed to call them brothers and sisters, saying, I will proclaim your name to my brothers and sisters. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. And again, I will put my trust in him. And again, here am I and the children whom God has given me. Since therefore the children share flesh and blood, he himself likewise shared the same things, so that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is, the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by the fear of death. For it is clear that he did not come to help angels, but the descendants of Abraham. Therefore, he had to become like his brothers and sisters in every respect, so that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest in the service of God, to make a sacrifice of atonement for the sins of the people. Because he himself was tested by what he suffered, he is able to help those who are being tested. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
gospel reading is from Luke 23. Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing, and the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him, saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, while the sun's light failed and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying out with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last. When the centurion saw what has taken place, he praised God and said, "Certainly this man was innocent." And when all the crowds who had gathered there for the spectacle saw what had taken place, they returned home beating their breast. But all his acquaintances, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance watching these things. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please be seated.
Thank you. 5 days before the Passover, the crowd that had come for the feast heard that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. Taking palm branches, they went out to meet him, shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel." Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it. As is written, "Rejoice greatly, daughters of Zion. See, your king comes to you, righteous and having salvation, gentle and riding on a donkey." We have no greater king than Christ, who will one day come again in glory. To those on his right, he will say, "Come inherit the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. Naked and you clothed me. Sick and you looked after me. In prison and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer, "Lord, when did we do these things?" The king will reply, "I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for the least of these, you did for me." Jesus and the disciples were at the table. He said to them, "I have eagerly waited to eat this Passover with you before I suffer." Taking the cup, he said, "This cup is my blood, which is poured out for you. Take it and drink." Then he took bread and broke it and said, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After the meal, the disciples began to argue as to which of them was considered greatest. Jesus said to them, "Who is greater, the one who is at the table or the one who serves? Is it not the one at the table? But I am among you as one who serves. Whoever wants to be first must be your servant, just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. Our attitude should be like that of Christ, who, being one with God, did not consider himself equal to God. Instead, he made himself nothing, taking the nature of a servant. We also must serve one another in love, following the example of Christ, for we have no greater servant. After they had eaten, Jesus went out with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane and asked them to keep watch while he prayed. He fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if you are willing, let this cup be taken from me. Yet not my will, but your will." And a second time he prayed, "Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, then thy will be done." Becoming human like us, Christ humbled himself and became obedient unto death. If we then are obedient to his commands, we can be assured that we have come to know him. For whoever claims to live in Jesus must walk as he did, for there is no greater obedience than this. Same night, Jesus was arrested, beaten, and brought before the authorities for questioning. The next morning, they brought him to a place called Golgotha, where they nailed him to a cross, and with him two thieves. Many of those watching hurled insults at him, but Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." Darkness fell over the whole land, and Jesus called out, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Then with a loud cry, he breathed his last and died. We have no greater sacrifice than this, that Christ offered himself for us. He became the atonement, not only for our sins, but for the sins of the whole world.
Thank you.
This is how God showed his love to us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice for our sins. Since God so loved us, we ought to love one another. There is no greater love than one who lays down his life for his friends.
Thank you.
Let us say the litany and the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray for the churches of God throughout the world.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray for people of other faith.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray for those who cannot believe.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray for God's creation and our care for the world.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray for the leaders and the people of all nations.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray for all those who suffer or are in need in any way.
Lord, have mercy.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Please stand for the closing hymn, it's 504.
Thank you.
so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son,
that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world,
but that the world through him might be saved.
To him who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and has made us kings and priests to his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen.